Hey guys, I promised a video on gear and here it is. This video is going to be over the big main items you're going to need when you're going hunting. I'll probably do another one later on about the fine details of some of the smaller items, but these are the basics. You go into the woods with the stuff that I'm suggesting and you'll be okay. First of all, since this is a hunting trip, you're going to need a firearm, 270 rifle, 270 caliber or bigger, with a scope, be able to shoot. Done. All right, now, in terms of camping gear, first item on the list, pack. This is a 3,500 square inch XO Mountain gear pack. This thing is thebomb.com. I absolutely love it. XO Mountain gear makes great packs. But they're the kind of packs for people that love gear and hate having money. So yeah, if you want to buy a big ticket top-end pack, love XO Mountain gear, you can talk to me. I actually did a ton of research before I finally bought this one. If you don't want to buy a pack, that's okay too. I actually have the pack that I used last year, which is an Alps Commander pack, perfectly fine. Heck, if you want to borrow the pack to just get some time with a load on your back training before this fall before the hunt, let me know. I'll ship it out to you so that you can get some practice. But that's it for packs. Next item on the list is a tent. This is the tent I'm going to be using. It's an MSR Hubba Hubba. You can see it's very small, very lightweight. It's a two-man backpacking tent. Again, I still have the tent that I used last year, which was a Cabela's XPG ultralight tent. It's perfectly fine. If you don't want to buy a tent, then I'll be happy to loan you that one. If you're out, if you're going to shop for tents, what you're looking for is probably a two-man tent, because a one-man tent, those are really small and claustrophobic. Don't know if you'd enjoy that, but two-man lightweight tent, you can find them on Amazon for $100 or less pretty easily. And again, I've got one you can borrow. Next on the list, sleeping bag. Ideally, you would like a ultralight goose down sleeping bag rated down to about 15 degrees. Those are a little bit on the expensive side, I'm not gonna lie. But again, just like the other items I had mentioned, I have the sleeping bag I used last year, which is a 22 degree Kelty synthetic bag that I put a liner in that, you know, adds another 10 degrees of insulation. So I've got something you can use. It's not heavy, good stuff. So if you don't want to spend a lot of money on a sleeping bag, I got you covered. If you do, then I have a Mountain Hardwear 15 degree goose down bag. Love that thing so far. All right, one thing I don't have to spare that you will 100% want is a sleeping pad. This is a Therm-a-Rest NeoAir sleeping pad. Super, super lightweight. It inflates and is very, very comfortable. The downside to inflatable sleeping pads is that they do have the possibility they can puncture, but they are really lightweight, super comfortable. I've used mine on several camping trips with no issues. That is one of the best sleeping pads out there on the market, so it's priced accordingly, but you can get yourself a good sleeping pad for $60, $70, $80. Do a little research, get a good sleeping pad, because they are the difference between being able to sleep at night and not when you're camping in the woods, sleeping on the ground. As far as other items, you're gonna want a navigation aid, a GPS, a compass, something like that. Now again, I'm not telling you, do not run out and buy the Garmin Montana $680 GPS unless you already wanted one of those, because I've got a GPS and I have a spare, so two people are gonna have GPSs in our unit just with what I've got. At the very least though, you should always at least have a compass with you. That way you don't get into a situation where you're really in bad shape. If you get separated from the group, you should at least know the trucks are parked to the road, the road's to the north, I'm gonna go north till I hit the road and I'll find the trucks and I'll be fine, and they won't make a documentary about me. Alright, binos. Binoculars are important. Again, I got a spare pair. These are some Vortex Viper HDs that I've been pretty happy with. They're very lightweight. I like them a lot. Highly recommend them. I've got a pair of Bushnells that are a little bigger, a little heavier, a lot more affordable, that if you want to borrow binos, I got you covered. As far as water carrying, you've got a couple of options there, actually. A lot of people love the like metal bottles, like this Clean Canteen. I, on the other hand, have just fallen in love with these Platypus water bladders. This is a 2-liter big zip water bladder that I keep in my backpack. I'm going to upgrade and get the 3-liter because just the ability to carry around a large quantity of water with you is really, really nice. And although I've heard people talk about burst water bladders, that thing seems to be pretty darn bulletproof. You'd have to almost intentionally abuse it, I think, to get it to leak. So yeah, love those. But again, you can get by with something like this. The problem with this, though, is this is only 40 ounces right there, whereas that's 70. This is round and solid. It doesn't conform. So yeah, there's a little bit of a trade-off. What I think is the most underrated piece of equipment that anybody on a hunting trip like we're going on to have is trekking poles. These things have literally saved my face on hike after hike after hike. When you've got a weight on your back, when you've got a pack, your balance is a big deal, and these help you maintain it. These are the Cascade Mountain Tech carbon fiber poles. I think they're like $44 on Amazon. You can get way more expensive ones. You can go to Walmart and pick up a cheap pair for $10 to $15. But having a pair of trekking poles, really, really important. They're lifesavers. In terms of clothing, merino wool base layer that's breathable, not like a thick wool sweater, but the merino wool base layers from places like, I think Cabela's has some, but First Light or Kuyu makes great ones. They're really breathable. They also don't hold in body odor, which is really, really nice. So there's that. One place to spend money, socks. Have good socks. Again, Kuyu, First Light, Cabela's, I own socks from multiple different companies. Lots of good socks out there. Something with some like athletic cut to them so that they're not just thick wool, you know, insulated blankets, but more an athletic cut sock with that merino wool there. You're gonna want to probably bring 2 or 3 pairs just because a few days in the woods and your feet are gonna stink even with merino wool. As far as boots, these are my hiking boots. They are Morel Boulders. They are Gore-Tex, they are lightweight hiking boots. They are not hunting boots. In my experience, most hunting boots are heavy, full leather upper things that just are a pain in the butt. So you want lightweight hiking boots. These are about 4 years old. They've lasted me 4 years and they were like $120, so they won't break the bank. Get you a good pair of hiking boots. Gore-Tex is nice, it's not an absolute must-have. You do want them to be above the ankles for that ankle support. Last thing I'll get to really, really quickly. This is no country for cotton underwear. Another place to spend some money. Get yourself some synthetic, like Under Armour Performance Boxer Briefs. First Light, their Arrow Wool and Red Desert boxer briefs are supposed to be absolutely outstanding, but you know, spend a little money. You spend a day or two out in country like this in cotton boxers or tighty whities, and you're going to be a grown man with diaper rash, and you don't need that. So yeah, that's a brief overview of gear. If you got questions, if you disagree with anything I had to say, hit me up. Let me know. We'll talk about it. Love you. Can't wait to see you out here.